there's a cloud don't mean there's rain. Tears in my eyes don't mean there's pain. Don't flatter yourself, I'm over you.
Things aren't always what they seem. You can't believe everything you read.
I was born in 1943, towards the end of the Second World War. I'm the fifth of five children. There were two big boys, and then came the twins in 1940, and then I came along as a real mistake. My mother thought I was the menopause.
I was born on November 11, which is quite a famous date in France, and I think all over the world, in French Morocco.
This guy was looking at me with insistence, and he moved a finger and said, come over here.
And I said, would you buy me a drink? It was just a way to introduce myself.
And I said to him,
said, get lost. I asked her if we could have dinner together.
And I said, we're going to Jerusalem.
And I said, you're mad. You're completely mad to go to Jerusalem.
You cannot go. I said, watch me. We had a very pleasant evening together, and it was fine because I knew the next day we were leaving anyway. Incidentally, I was already engaged to an English guy. This was my last fling.
The next morning, I went down for breakfast, and I was quite surprised. There were no English people at all. He flew me to the airport, and we arrived just a few minutes before the passengers were boarding.
To walk across the runway in those days, and as we were walking across the runway, what do we hear?
Eight! And she turned her head towards me and they said, you didn't give me your phone number.
And that is the beginning of the beautiful story. So after that, many things happened, of course, including the fact that I would zip across to Paris on romantic weekends and had to break up with the fiancé, which was a little bit difficult, as we were very near to the point of moving into this wonderful home that had just been built and being married. So that broke up and I finally moved to Paris.
Creo que un extranjero va más allá de ir a otro país o emigrar a otro país. Es acerca de una cultura, es acerca de ir a un lugar donde no estás acostumbrado a las costumbres, es otra comida, otros horarios, es acostumbrarse a sociabilizar en una manera diferente, en salir de tu zona de confort y tener una mente abierta a cosas diferentes.
Coucou maman, ça va? Bon du coup là je te fais un vocal vite fait pour te dire ce qu'il en est d'aujourd'hui parce que ça fait au moins 5 jours que je t'ai pas parlé. Du coup, ce matin je suis allée en classe, hein. C'est la classe que j'aime pas trop, la communication politique. Et après je suis... Ah oui, j'ai parlé un peu avec Audrey. Elle est au front desk, du coup tout le temps quand elle y est, je lui parle. Et après, je suis allée à un événement avec ma classe de sciences politiques. Un étranger.
Pour toi.
Pour moi, bon, c'est pas seulement dans l'immigration, le premier terme... auquel on pense est un étranger, donc du coup dans l'immigration, il y a eu quelque chose qui l'a push ou bien quelque chose qui l'a pull, donc d'un pays, soit quelque chose qui l'a poussé à partir comme un réfugié, ou bien quelque chose qui l'a attiré comme une opportunité économique dans un autre pays. Donc il y a ce premier terme auquel on pense directement, mais bon, étranger c'est tellement plus vaste, c'est quand on est juste quelque chose nous est inconnu, donc soit on arrive dans un endroit qui nous est inconnu, ou on fait une découverte avec une population qui nous est inconnue, ou bien justement, elle est connue pour cet étranger, mais c'est l'étranger en fait qui est inconnu à cette nouvelle population, ce nouveau territoire. Et du coup, bah, là, ça peut être encore plus difficile peut-être, parce que justement, à cause de cette rejection, cette discrimination, etc.
And I love you too, my baby. Thanks for your message. It sounded very rapid, but I was thrilled to hear your voice. And Wednesday afternoon, late afternoon, because we're taking Nina to the doctor because she's got a pain in her ankle. So we are taking her at 1 o'clock to the doctor, but we will be home later. So speak to you later on Wednesday, and I love you, darling. Bye.
Mamu, ¿cómo estás? Che, discúlpame, recién te puedo hablar. Es que estuve en clase todo el día. Recién salgo, estoy yendo a casa. Y nada, voy a cenar y hacer un poco de tarea. ¿Ustedes cómo andan? ¿Todo bien?
Yes, I remember it well, Wendy's. Yes, I remember the moments. And Natalie's lost a lot of weight since then, though, so she's gone skinny. But bon voyage, darling. Hope you get there safely and comfortably. I hope there's not too much wind and rain. And thinking of you. Lots of love, my sweetheart.
We are a family of flute players, so our house was always filled with lovely music, and I appreciated every second.
J'ai eu l'expérience d'être une étrangère et aussi d'arriver sur un territoire qui est étranger à moi, mais je pense que je suis plus étrangère à ce territoire que ce territoire étranger à moi dû à mon expérience.
the best thing to do is what you do by yourself, what you get by yourself. That's the only real thing you can rely on. And love.